Bamboo is one of the fastest growing plants in the world. Some species can grow up to 91 centimeters a day under the right conditions. Technically, bamboo isn't even a tree, it's a giant grass. That means once it's cut, it grows back from its roots. It doesn't need replanting or fertilizers. An oak tree takes 40 to 60 years to mature. However, some bamboos can reach maturity in just 3 to 5 years. This allows them to produce 3 to 4 times more fiber per unit area than trees. That makes bamboo much more advantageous than trees for paper and cardboard production. 1 hectare of bamboo forest absorbs an average of 12 tons of CO2 per year, while producing 35 tons of oxygen. In other words, bamboos provide about 35% more oxygen than many trees covering the same area. Some bamboo species exhibit tensile strength values close to those of steel, and their fibers are resistant to burning due to high silica content. This feature provides a particular advantage as a building material, especially in tropical regions. In Asia and Latin America, bamboo is used in constructing houses, bridges, scaffolding, and even bicycles. In Colombia, bamboo is considered a building material as strong as steel. Fabrics made from its fibers are breathable, antibacterial, and biodegradable. Thanks to the natural biopolymers it contains, bioplastics can be produced from bamboo. These materials can be used in food packaging and kitchen products. Bamboo products, unlike plastics, are made from natural fibers and can compost in 2 to 6 months under suitable conditions. This makes it a highly eco-friendly product. All these qualities have led many to call bamboo the new wood and even the plastic of the future. But is it really that perfect? Can it truly replace plastic? Let's take a closer look. What makes bamboo such a great alternative lies in its biological and chemical makeup. It's light, strong, and resistant to corrosion, basically a natural composite material. The medium length and high tear resistance of bamboo fibers make it suitable for paper pulp. In industrial facilities, bamboo chips are cooked with alkaline solutions at around 145 degrees Celsius using the Kraft process. After a 4 to 5 hour cooking period, they're ground in pulpers and go through washing, screening, and bleaching stages. This process is similar to wood pulp, but completes in a shorter time. And bamboo pulp offers high tear strength and low cost thanks to its medium length fibers. A well-designed bamboo paper is suitable for high-quality papers used in book printing or for cardboard packaging. Better Packaging Company reports that it produces bamboo paper without bleaching, using soy-based inks and non-toxic adhesives, thus developing packaging that's both recyclable and compostable. The company also emphasizes that its products are not more expensive than comparable paper or cardboard packaging. When bamboo fibers are mixed with starch and other biopolymers, they can produce single-use plates, cups, and straws that are resistant to water, oil, and heat. An academic review reports that plates made by mixing bamboo fiber with tapioca starch provide high mechanical strength, water and oil resistance, and fully biodegrade. The same study highlights that bamboo straws made without any chemicals have high mechanical properties and low cost. Some innovative and eco-friendly companies have started using bamboo paper or fiber composites instead of plastic packaging. For example, the China-based Suncha brand produces bamboo plates, cutlery, and food packaging, applying sustainable harvesting practices to minimize waste, reports reducing energy use by 30% and waste production by 40% in its processes. However, there is a critical question mark that we will address shortly. Technology company Lenovo aims to reduce traditional foam materials by using molds made from bamboo fibers in laptop packaging. This shrinks the packaging volume per unit and reduces carbon emissions during shipping. As of 2024, the global bamboo market was valued at $67.1 billion, and it's expected to reach $88.4 billion by 2030, growing about 4.7% per year. Around 79% of this market is in the Asia-Pacific region, with China holding about 59% of the global share. Furniture and paper are still the biggest sectors, but eco-friendly packaging and retail products are growing fast thanks to consumer demand and government incentives. Bamboo plantations create income sources, especially for developing countries. Their minimal maintenance needs and rapid growth offer farmers stable harvesting opportunities. But can we really call bamboo the plastic of the future or the new wood? For paper and packaging, maybe yes. But when it comes to food packaging or kitchen products, things get more complicated. That's because most bamboo plastics aren't pure bamboo. They're composites, mixtures of bamboo fibers and chemical resins or polymers that hold everything together. To bind natural bamboo fibers together, chemical resins and adhesives are often used. Formaldehyde-based melamine resins are commonly preferred for wood and bamboo composites. However, these substances can cause formaldehyde and melamine release during production and use. In 2024, the UK Food Standards Agency and Food Standards Scotland warned consumers that formaldehyde and melamine could leach from melamine resin plastic cups containing bamboo fibers, and long-term exposure could lead to kidney damage and gastrointestinal issues. European food authorities reported that in 11% of tested products, formaldehyde migration exceeded legal limits, and in 25%, melamine did. Therefore, it has come to light that some products marketed as 100% bamboo are actually bamboo powder melamine mixtures and could pose health risks when in contact with hot beverages. Due to this danger, in February 2021, authorities in the Benelux countries, Belgium, Netherlands, and Luxembourg, instructed businesses to immediately withdraw these bamboo melamine plastics used for food contact from the EU market. Scientific reviews indicate that plant fiber plastic composites can leach not only formaldehyde and melamine, but also phthalates, benzophenones, and perfluoroalkyl substances, like oil and water-repellent chemicals, when in contact with food. The European Union is preparing stricter regulations on bamboo composite materials in contact with food. To prevent consumer deception, agendas include clearly stating material components on labels and limiting the use of melamine-containing products. There are also companies offering alternatives with more natural components, at least reducing the effects of melamine. However, points that need careful examination remain to say they're completely melamine-free and risk-free. Light My Fire uses plant-based bioplastics like cornstarch and sugarcane. The company specifically states, "We do not use melamine or bamboo melamine plastics in our products. Their products have been tested for compliance with FDA and EU food contact standards." Bobo & Boo uses bamboo fiber and claims that all of its products are melamine-free, with the statement, "Entirely free of melamine, BPA, and phthalates." Meanwhile, the Yumi Eco brand uses the phrase melamine-free for its natural bamboo dinner plate series. A seller on this website lists their products like this: "It's a combination of bamboo fiber, cornstarch, polylactic acid. However, detailed independent migration tests, temperature limits, and certifications should be checked." Despite these alternative solutions, bamboo composite plates and bowls containing melamine are still common, and there have been cases where migration tests detected melamine or formaldehyde levels exceeding legal limits. Certificates and test results vary from product to product. Some are explicitly labeled as melamine-free, while others carry that label but have still been publicly reported to contain materials that may pose a risk of melamine or formaldehyde migration. From a cost perspective, these alternative products also remain generally more expensive. The scale of production, raw material processing, and the performance of bio-based adhesives all contribute to this higher cost. Today, bamboo is called the steel of nature. It grows fast, adapts easily, and captures more CO2 than forests. But its true potential as a new plastic lies not only in its green image, it's in its industrial versatility. The challenge is cost. Turning bamboo fibers into bioplastic is still expensive. Blends with cornstarch, bioresins, and minerals are promising, but large-scale production hasn't reached the level needed to compete with global plastic manufacturing. If the cost of producing bamboo-based bioplastics can be reduced, bamboo could truly become a strong, sustainable alternative to plastic. And even beyond plastics, bamboo's quiet revolution is happening in paper and cardboard. Its long, durable fibers require fewer chemicals, and countries like China, India, and Indonesia are already producing millions of tons of bamboo paper, easing pressure on traditional forests. So, in the future, bamboo might not compete with plastic, but transform it. If technology can make bamboo-based bioplastics cheap and scalable, this simple, hollow-stemmed plant from nature could provide a real answer to the modern world's overflowing plastic problem. Thanks for watching us. See you in the next video.